As the co-host of ITV breakfast show Good Morning Britain, Susanna Reid is used to covering tragic and traumatic events with all the composure you'd expect from an experienced journalist, newsreader and TV presenter. But in her new project, a powerful one-off documentary for ITV's Crime Punishment season, Susanna explores the 2015 murder of 16-year-old Becky Watts, and it did take an emotional toll on the mum of three. The murder of Becky Watts. Susanna reveals the tactics police used to catch Becky's killers in the hour-long program. As a journalist, you deal with a lot of horror, so you develop a certain armor to switch your emotions off, but there are times when that armor just crumbles, admits the 46-year-old, who visited the home where Becky was murdered to speak to the victim's dad Darren and stepmom Angie. In those moments, you are no longer a journalist, you are someone who knows what it would be like. Your heart and soul just goes out to them. Afterwards, you realize you have been much more affected by it than you thought. It does make you go home and hug your own kids' sons Sam, 15, Finn, 13, and Jack, 12, that bit tighter at night because you see the true devastation of what some parents experience. I am very grateful that I have my kids, and those simple pleasures like cooking with them or just hanging out become much more important with that in mind. Obviously, I don't want my children to bear the responsibilities of my job, so you have to leave it at the door because you'd be a wreck, but sometimes I wonder where the darker things lodge in your brain. I hope what it does is make you have an appreciation for the good things in life, while having an understanding of the pain some families go through. The murder of Becky Watts. Police tapes in her new project, a powerful one-off documentary for ITV's Crime Punishment season. Susanna explores the 2015 murder of 16-year-old Becky Watts, and it did take an emotional toll on the mum of three. Becky Watts' family endured unimaginable horror from the moment the teenager disappeared without a trace from her home in Bristol on the 19th of February 2015, and the case sparked a nationwide manhunt. The hashtag #FindBecky just spread on social media, and there was a collective effort to find her, recalls Susanna. I think we all remember seeing those striking photos of Becky and what a typical 16-year-old she was. However, any hope of Becky being found alive faded when, 12 days later, her body was discovered in a shed near to the home of Angie's son Nathan Matthews, then 28, and his 21-year-old girlfriend Shauna Hoare. One of the things that raised a red flag was because her friends kept coming to the house and asking where she was, says Susanna. Everyone started gathering round to help, but there were two people who were reluctant to come in for questioning, and you'd imagine they would be two of the first people who would want to help her stepbrother and his girlfriend. When they eventually do go in for questioning, it emerges they are the last people to see Becky before she was reported missing. It transpired that Nathan had suffocated the schoolgirl to death in her bedroom, before moving her body to his home where he dismembered her corpse in the bathtub with a circular saw. Becky Watts' family endured unimaginable horror from the moment the teenager disappeared without a trace from her home in Bristol on the 19th of February 2015, Susanna Reid jokingly branded Dirty Stop out after having 4 hours sleep. GMB fans furious as Piers Morgan again replaced by Richard Madeley. Susanna Reid reveals how she goes from horror show to pin-up. Susanna Reid meets twin as Piers Morgan learns Robert the Bruce's family. GMB fans rage at patronizing Richard Madeley and hyper Ranveer Singh, and while he claims Shauna had no involvement, a series of uncovered text messages between him and his girlfriend showed they shared a sick obsession with teenage girls and kidnap fantasies. It's interesting to look back at how the police gradually find out information from the interviews, going back to the forensics. How much do you reveal to the person you are questioning? At what point are they going to decide to shut down? Explains Susanna. It's such a dance. It's the unpeeling of all those layers of the investigation. It's fascinating. One of the oddest things in the footage is the way that Shauna is so coolly and calmly talking in her first police interviews. She claims she knew nothing about it. Then as the evidence comes through with Becky's blood on a doorframe and Nathan's fingerprint in the blood, she keeps lying and lying. At some points in the interviews, she is giggling and laughing. It's very uncomfortable too. Some of the most chilling footage is of the police searching Nathan and Shauna's house. It's like a hoarder's house, every surface covered with junk, then the camera switches to the bath and it's spotless. It sticks out like a sore thumb. like a needle in a haystack. The police find a receipt for a circular saw in drawers near the bathroom. Susanna Reid is on the cover of this week's TV mag. An expert in the trial said Nathan couldn't have dismembered the body by himself. In November last year, Nathan was convicted of murder and sentenced to life in prison with a minimum of 33 years. Shauna was found guilty of manslaughter and handed a 17-year sentence. Angie has to deal every day with the fact that her son killed the daughter of the man she loves, says Susanna. I asked her if she ever wanted to believe her son did it as an accident, and she said not for a moment. She knew he had done it deliberately. The program, which features previously unseen home videos of Becky and shocking police interviews with her killers, is the first documentary of this kind Susanna has fronted, but if she wanted any advice on the true crime genre, she need look no further than her Good Morning Britain co-host and Killer Women presenter, Piers Morgan. I'm sure Piers would love to give me advice about everything, but I think we're doing two very different things, Susanna says of the comparisons to Piers' work. He sits down with killers in America, but in this country, there is a legal framework that prevents that from happening. Victim Becky Watts was 16 when she was murdered. Dad of Becky Watts speaks out after tragic murder of his daughter. Doing this documentary is a completely different challenge to presenting GMB. We have someone on the sofa in the morning and interview them for a few minutes, so with this it's nice to be given the opportunity to delve into things a bit more. Not that she has any plans to trade her day job for more primetime presenting gigs. Doing Good Morning Britain is the best job on television and I love what I do, she smiles, adding that her relationship with Piers has changed a lot in the 2 years they have been working together. I described him as a mini tornado to start with, but I underplayed it. He was a blown hurricane. I do get a lot out of the partnership and he challenges me. We have very, very different opinions, not just about politics. We have rows about the way things should be done on the program. How the Sun reported the murder of the school girl at the hands of twisted killer Matthews, an accomplice whore. I have never worked with anyone who rubs me up the wrong way quite as much as Piers does, and at the beginning, we regularly had run-ins, but we have always sorted things out and we're genuine friends. While Piers may embrace the likes of Twitter and his celebrity status, Susanna leads a very non-celeb life away from the cameras. I am just a mum of three who happens to be on TV, she says. I would say I'm known, which is different to being a celebrity. People vaguely recognize me, but they don't know where they know me from. There's nothing like someone coming up to you and asking, "Are you famous?" to remind you that you are not. I go home and there is nothing celebrity about my life. It's really just about making tea and trying to persuade my boys to a film with me while they are still at the age where they will. I'm trying to hold on to that as long as I can. Neither Nathan nor Shauna has revealed the nature of what happened that fateful day over 2 years ago, so Becky's dad Darren above with Nathan's mom Angie can never get closure. Nathan has never admitted to murdering Becky, reveals Susanna. He admits to killing her, and his confession is read back to him in a very striking scene in the police tapes while he has his fingers in his ears. He can't even listen to his own statements. It's a very odd, chilling moment. And he claims Shauna had nothing to do with it and was in the garden the whole time. Obviously that was ignored as she was convicted of manslaughter. At the Watts home, Susanna was taken into the bedroom where Becky D. Darren told me that he still has nightmares because it is left to his imagination to try to work out what happened to Becky, reveals Susanna. Her bedroom is kept locked, but her dad unlocked it and showed me the room. It's probably the first time since the case that it has been shown on TV. It's clean and tidy and there are no signs of what happened, but it's pretty much untouched from how Becky lived in it. The only difference is that there are pictures and toys that were given to the family after she died. There are memories of Becky all over the house. New the murder of Becky Watts police tapes Thursday 9 p.m. ITV.